If you have been experiencing achy, stiff joints, you may be wondering, do I have polymyalgia rheumatica or PMR or rheumatoid arthritis? Well, they share some similar symptoms. There are also key differences between these two types of arthritis. Today, we will answer a lot of questions like, what are the main signs of polymyalgia rheumatica and rheumatoid arthritis? What are the main differences between these two diseases? What laboratory test do we use to distinguish between them? Can PMR or polymyalgia rheumatica mimic rheumatoid arthritis? Or can PMR lead to rheumatoid arthritis? And I will briefly introduce you to the treatment of these diseases. Are you ready? Let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
What are the main signs of polymyalgia rheumatica and rheumatoid arthritis? Now, both polymyalgia rheumatica, or as we call it PMR, and rheumatoid arthritis can cause pain and stiffness in the joints. But while PMR primarily affects the shoulders and the hip area, in rheumatoid arthritis, most patients will experience pain in the hands and feet. Of course, shoulders and hips can be affected in rheumatoid arthritis, but it's more rare to start there. Patients with PMR will usually experience pain and stiffness in the shoulders that will cause difficulties using their arms, like raising their arms above their heads and even cause weakness. If PMR affects the hips, then patients will experience difficulties getting out of the bed, getting out of the chair, or even getting out of the car after a prolonged sitting period. Plus, patients with PMR experience a lot of morning stiffness that would last at least 45 minutes. As the day goes by, with movement, the stiffness will improve gradually. Very similar to PMR, patients with rheumatoid arthritis will have pain, swelling, and morning stiffness in the joints that will also improve with movement. As you can see, very similar, but different joints affected. Some patients with PMR or polymyalgia rheumatica can develop fever, night sweats, and also weight loss. If you develop headaches, that can be a sign of a more complicated disease called temporal arteritis or giant cell arteritis. If you want to learn more about this potential complication, watch this video in my channel. These shared symptoms can make polymyalgia rheumatica tricky to distinguish from rheumatoid arthritis, especially early on. However, some key characteristics set them apart. What are the main differences between polymyalgia rheumatica and rheumatoid arthritis? The timing seems to be different. In PMR, the onset can be gradual, but many of the patients that I have described that they have symptoms coming overnight. So when they went to bed, they were fine, but in the morning they wake up in severe pain and they could not move. That is rare in rheumatoid arthritis, where usually pain, swelling, and stiffness tend to develop more gradually. The age of onset for patients is also important, because classically PMR affects people over 50 years old, especially over 65 years old, while rheumatoid arthritis tends to affect females between 30 and 50 years old. As we discussed, the types of joints affected are usually different between PMR and rheumatoid arthritis. The shoulders and hips are the targets in PMR, while in rheumatoid arthritis, the hand and feet are most impacted. The morning stiffness tend to last a little bit longer in PMR than in rheumatoid arthritis. And despite the fact that PMR is so painful and disabling, it doesn't damage the joints. In fact, inflammation is more around the joints capsules in the shoulders and hips. On the other hand, in rheumatoid arthritis, the inflammation will damage the joints if left untreated. There are also differences regarding the treatment that we will address a little bit later in this video. So continue to watch to learn more. What laboratory tests do you use to distinguish between them? Most of the time, when I have a patient presenting with severe pain and stiffness in the shoulders and hips, I do order a complete panel of labs, including tests that will rule out rheumatoid arthritis. What is specific for PMNR is that markers of inflammation like sedimentation rate or C-reactive protein can be very elevated, sometimes with an ESR or a SED rate reaching up to 100. We do see elevated markers of inflammation in rheumatoid arthritis, but they are not typically so high. In polymyalgia rheumatica, rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP antibodies are negative, unlike rheumatoid arthritis, where many times at least one of these antibodies are positive. X-rays are usually not helpful to diagnose PMNR, so we don't order them unless we suspect something else is happening. Can PMNR mimic rheumatoid arthritis, or can PMNR lead to rheumatoid arthritis? The answer is yes. PMNR can mimic rheumatoid arthritis. That means that rheumatoid arthritis can start looking like PMNR with pain and swelling in the shoulders and hips, and then later on can involve other joints. As I discussed in another video, there are forms of seronegative rheumatoid arthritis where all the markers are negative, including inflammatory markers, rheumatoid factor, and anti-CCP antibodies, but patients can still have rheumatoid arthritis. That is why it's important to have an experienced rheumatologist to evaluate your signs, your symptoms, and not only rely on your labs and x-rays. If you develop PMNR, it's best to be under the care of a rheumatologist who will evaluate you, treat you, but also monitor you to make sure that your symptoms are not actually early signs of rheumatoid arthritis. I will briefly introduce you to the treatment of PMNR and rheumatoid arthritis. PMNR patients respond very quickly and very well to steroids. Actually, a low dose of steroids like 15-20 mg per day will have a great effect. If you have PMNR and you start on steroids, your symptoms will resolve within the next few days. However, the steroid dose needs to be tapered down slowly. And I want to emphasize, slowly. It may take 6 months to a year to 2 years to get off steroids. And this is a common mistake that I see. Patients receive steroids, they feel great, but then the medication is tapered too quickly, often bringing back worse symptoms. For some patients, we cannot take steroids or who we want to spare them from the potential steroid side effect, we can use other medications like methotrexate or newer medications like sarilumab. I will talk more about the PMNR treatment options in depth in another video, so don't forget to subscribe to learn more on this topic. When it comes to rheumatoid arthritis, the treatment approach is a little bit more complex. Despite the fact that steroids can temporarily decrease inflammation, decrease pain, they are not the long-term treatment. They are just a bridge to help your symptoms until additional medications will fully kick in. Other drugs that we use for rheumatoid arthritis are DMARDs, biologics, which will prevent the joint damage. And this is the goal of treatment in rheumatoid arthritis. If you want to learn more about the latest rheumatoid arthritis treatments, you should check out this video in my channel. The main takeaway, yes, polymyalgia rheumatica symptoms can mimic rheumatoid arthritis initially. However, paying close attention to details like what joints are involved, the timing of stiffness, the disease course, the blood test results, and the treatment response will all help us distinguish correctly between these two conditions, polymyalgia rheumatica and rheumatoid arthritis. If you need a rheumatologist to help you diagnose and treat potential rheumatoid arthritis or polymyalgia rheumatica, my company, Rheumatologist on Call, is able to assist patients in multiple US states. So don't forget to check my website and learn about how we can help. Please leave me any comments that you have, any questions in the section below. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you soon.
RheumatologistOnCall.com